Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. In this video, I am going to demonstrate you how you can print these two patterns with C programming. You can note my information. If you want to follow or subscribe my YouTube channel, you can use this link, that is youtube.com/SanjayGupta_TechSchool. You can download my Android app, that is TechMS, which is available on Google Play. Now coming on to the pattern. First, I have to demonstrate you how this pattern will be printed. So you can see here some space is available and then digits are printed. So you can analyze this with this table. Here you can see I have used hyphen sign in place of space so that I can count how many spaces are required to print this pattern in each row. So you can see in first row spaces are 4 and digits are 1. Then in second row, 3 spaces are required and 2 digits. Then in third row, 2 spaces and 3 digits. In fourth row, 1 space and 4 digits. In fifth row, 0 space and 5 digits. So here, first loop will be for printing spaces in each row and second loop will be for printing digits in each row. Then third loop will be required to control in which row these spaces and digits will be printed. So now you can see this code. Here first loop is available which will repeat n times. N is received through this printf and scanf and n is representing number of rows. So first loop is starting from 1, it will repeat n times. So n number of rows will be displayed. Then first spaces will be displayed in first row through this loop. So suppose n is 5 and first time I is 1. So this loop will repeat 4 times. And 4 spaces will be displayed. Then through this loop will repeat k times and digits will be printed through this loop. And here if condition is available, so here I is representing row number. So if row number is divisible by 2, then it will print 0 in a particular row. If I is not divisible by 2, then 1 will be printed in a particular row. So you can see the pattern. In odd rows 1 is printed and in even rows 0 is printed. So if I is divisible by 2, then it is even, so 0 will be printed, otherwise 1 will be printed. Then after completion of k, new line will be displayed through slash n. So this way first pattern will be displayed. You can see the output. You can compare it with this pattern. Both are same. Now we have to print its reverse, that is in first row 5 1, then 4 0, then 3 1, 2 0 and 1. So for this I just have to modify this pattern, sorry, this code, and I am modifying only first loop. So I equals to n, condition is I greater than equals to 1 and I minus minus. So I have just modified first loop. So it is initializing I by n. So suppose n is 5. So I will be also 5. Then this loop will repeat 0 times because 5 minus 5 is 0. And k loop will repeat 5 times. And it will print 5 times 1. Because I is not divisible by 2. So 1 will be printed 5 times. Then new line. Then I will be decremented. So its value will be 4. Then second time. 5 minus 4, it will print 1 space and I loop will be repeated 4 times. This time I is 4, which is divisible by 2. So 4 times zeros will be displayed. So this way reverse of the pattern will be displayed on console. Again I am entering number of rows as 5. Now you can again compare the output. Both are same, but this time pattern is printed in reverse order. So friends, I hope you have understood how we can print both the patterns with the help of nested loops in C programming. If you want to watch more programming related videos, you can follow this link, that is youtube.com/SanjayGupta_TechSchool. Thank you for watching this video.